My name is Moshe Ben Akiva. I'm a professor in the Department of Civil and Environmental Engineering. I teach a course on discrete choice analysis, methods to analyze model human behavior and predict human behavior. It's a 5-day course. Every day has 3 lectures. And then the 4th session is a computer lab where we give the students some software and some data that they get to analyze so that they get hands-on experience in the methods and algorithms that they studied during the day. And we do it day by day, making progress from basic to more advanced methods toward the end of the week.
Every day we make decisions. And we decide if to marry or not to marry. We decide if to buy a car versus a motorbike, or bike to work, or take a taxi, or take a tram, or whatever other type of transportation. So discrete choice methods help us to understand what are the factors that influence choice behavior, but also to predict choices for forecasting of demand or policy purposes, but also to help companies to better plan productions in order to optimize capacity and so forth. A lot of emphasis nowadays is on big data. And if we think about the application of big data in demand analysis or in discrete choice model, we should take a step back and think about what is really the use of having so much information. We know about the velocity of information, we know about the volume of information, and we know also about the variety of information, so richer data. One of the key learning from this course is the importance of utilizing data for testing and learning and doing the utilizing the proper method for choice experiment. What do we mean by that? One of the basic principles in nature is to do experiment. You do experiment and you learn, you improve, and you progress. Through this course, we will have a strong emphasis in designing powerful experiments, taking advantage of big data and all the different methods also available in machine learning and artificial intelligence. And at MIT, students can understand where the field has started, but also the state of the art of the field. So they will leave MIT with a broad range of tools and methods in order to apply the best of this field in their everyday work.